No list of distant running rivalries would be complete without a nod to the two countries that have owned the sport over the last quarter century, Kenya and Ethiopia. While both East African countries have produced their fair share of the world and Olympic champions, the lead or the head-to-head matchup that trumps up all others is the one between Ethiopian Haile Gebrselassie and Kenyan Paul Tergat, the emperor versus the gentleman. The rivalry between Paul Tergat and Haile Gebrselassie remained one of the best ever. Big hub was a 5'4". Gebrselassie in those two races, which tested his will way beyond the point at which most people would have hailed a taxi. And the story began more than a decade earlier. Gebrselassie's introduction to the big time athletics was outrageous. Those of us who have seen him rack up victories, medals, and world records since that novice excursion have a pretty clear idea of how he did it. With the same grit, tenacity, and willpower that brought him all the success in the following two decades, and which was never more evident than one on that night in Sydney in a brutal battle of guts and desire against a man he calls his friend. Although Tergat is supposedly 4 years older than Gebrselassie, the Kenyan introduction to big-time athletics came 2 or 3 years after Gebrselassie's painful debut. Tergat breakthrough race came in early 1992, then 22. He had placed third in a high-profile military race, but no one expected him to win the Nairobi Championship at the famous Ngong Racecourse. He soon proved he was a no fluke, though winning the national title on the same course 2 weeks later. Almost as striking as was his modest whisper, close to inaudible when interviewed after his victories a month later, he was mortified that an injury prevented him from running the IAAF World Cross Country Championship in Boston. It's likely he would have found his compatriot, multi-champion John Gukki, unbeatable that day. After that, frequently for Gebrselassie, he didn't win all races in 1993, but he did win the biggest, the World Championship 10,000 meters in Stuttgart. That it was the first World Track Championship gold for an Ethiopian gave the youngster the potential to build a status to rival Bikila. And build he did. The following year, if he had been running for any other nation than Kenya, a half marathon time of 60 minutes and 43 seconds was an indication of his cross-country and marathon potential in Europe. In 1996, Atlanta Games was the race that raised the Gebrselassie and Tergat rivalry to the something of a par with the great post-war rivals, while the last grabs into the last lap, the final 250 meters and ultimately the finishing straight. Atlanta was the full 15 minutes of breathtaking grammar and extended acceleration, first by Tergat's teammates and then a scorching final 2,000 meters by Tergat himself. Tergat dominated cross-country for the rest of the century, but fared no better in his next two world championships. At 10,000 meters in Athens in 1997, Gebrselassie took over 5,000 meters from the finish and blew him away. Tergat got some consolation, and a month later when he broke Gebrselassie's 10,000 meters world record, but the Ethiopian regained in 1998. Then in world championship in Seville in 1999, it was the same old story. Gebrselassie for gold, Tergat for silver. Gebrselassie, on the other hand, was battling an Achilles tendon injury that would eventually require surgery. It affected his training so seriously that he considered pulling out of Sydney, yet pressure from all sides and the internal urge to defend his title took him to the starting line. But beating his time, and there were five at least in pack at the bell, three Kenyans and two Ethiopians. Leading was John Korir, tracked closely by Gebrselassie. Despite Gebrselassie's relative lack of prime fitness, he knew Tergat was the only threat. This was his chance, maybe his last chance, his only chance to beat the man who he had bested him in 3 consecutive major world championships and 10,000 meters Olympic history. With a finishing tape long since abandoned, Tergat had only an approximate idea of line, whereas Gebrselassie had the advantage of Tergat's back as a target. And it was getting as close as meters in around 12 seconds, and Gebrselassie had won by a mere 900 of a second. he couldn't run another step. Kepresilashi had done what every runner in history had wanted to, run himself to the ground to win, which is why, despite the close title world records, this was his supreme achievement. Terk had now realized that he had been wrong, terribly wrong, to believe that he could beat Kepresilashi in a sprint. He knew, and he admitted later, and as Kepresilashi himself admitted, that Ethiopian could have been the legend, Kepresilashi and Paul Tergat. But you know what? Paul Tergat would eventually upstage Gugge and well outpace Kepresilashi as the most successful cross-country runner of 20th century, winning 5 consecutive cross-country championship in titles from 1995 to 1999. Kepresilashi would never hit the height of cross-country that he did on the track, twice finishing adrift of Tergat victories. Behind Tergat's win, he never ran cross-country again. Thank you for this tale of Tergat and Kepresilashi.